Well, hi kids. I'm using DrawThings, the image and video generator for Mac and iOS. It's free on the app stores and can be downloaded directly from drawthings.ai. Today I'm focusing on video generation using Hunyuan Video and showing a couple of derivative models, SkyReels V1 and Hunyuan FastVideo. There's a new control net called LoRA Image Prompt that works like an IP adapter. And I've tried an online source for training Hunyuan character LoRAs. We can't train them and draw things, but we can import them. I'll show you the steps. There's a warning, all AI video models are large and very slow. This workflow is not for everyone. You will need at least 16 gigabytes of RAM to render locally. And I watched my Mac spike to over 25 gigabytes in RAM usage. And I'm not even at full 720p resolution. Now, I have a previous tutorial on my channel introducing Hunyuan Video, explaining the parameters and how to export videos from DrawThings. So check that video first if you need the basics. Everything today is an add-on that builds on Hunyuan Video. It's March 2025 and information in open source AI changes very fast. The video features in DrawThings are still evolving and new video models are on the way, like in the next few weeks, if not days. So subscribe if you want to be notified. You know how YouTube works. Now the latest updates to DrawThings have added support for CFG and de-distilled models, like SkyReels V1. This unlocks negative prompts and initial support for image to video using the SkyReels I2V model. Now SkyReels is available in the DrawThings community downloads with a sister model for text to video. And SkyReels has some instructions in the model description when you load it up, specifically how to switch off speed up with text embeddings. Now this exposes the text embed parameter and allows for negative prompts, and the internet wisdom suggests that SkyReels needs a negative prompt in this mode. And as if the name didn't give it away, this is a lot slower than running it with speed up switched on. The parameters are otherwise the same as Hunyuan, but the fine-tuning, which is mostly people and talking avatars, suggests that renders will be at 24 frames per second. It also adds that to the text prompt. Now I got a handful of successful image-to-video renders, but to be perfectly honest, most of them had a camera transition that faded to black, or faded to another camera angle within a few frames. And this is a known issue with the SkyReels Lite model. There are a lot of complaints and discussions on their GitHub and the Hugging Face community comments. The professional SkyReels is a subscription service with hooks to control the model for talking portraits and avatars. This avatar workflow does not exist in DrawThings, and honestly, I never get good results from a de-distilled models. So I'm not gonna stay too long on SkyReels, but as a quick image to video tutorial, just add your image to the canvas. Make sure it completely covers the canvas to not trigger in painting. And leave image to image switched off, that is, prompt strength stays at 100%. Now, the image on the canvas will be the first image in the generated video, and it continues from there. And you add to the text prompt all the changes that you want to see happen. Now, like I said, I did not have a high success rate. I actually had better success generating with an older image to video model called Animate LCM. I may need to give SkyReels another chance, but other image-to-video models are coming very soon, so I'll save a deeper discussion for another video, when we can compare them.
Do it.
Now, a model that I am loving is an accelerated version of Hunyuan. It's called Hunyuan FastVideo. Hunyuan Fast is like other acceleration models that we can use in DrawThings. It's very similar quality to the original, but renders in less than 10 steps. And like other accelerated models, we can use either the full model or a LoRA. Hunyuan Fast is not in the community downloads. We'll have to download it. I'll add links to the video descriptions for both. Now, to import the model, download using the link from Hugging Face. In DrawThings, open the model drop-down list and select Manage at the top of the list. Find the Import tab on the Model Manager panel. The first prompt asks you for the URL or the file. And we can rename the model if it helps to search for it later. And lastly, this is a 13GB model. You'll need at least double that space on your hard drive to unpack and install. You'll also need to have a previously downloaded Hunyuan model from the community downloads to get the LLaVA encoder. If all this sounds too complicated, I'll just show the LoRA import later in this video. Now, I tried both. The LoRA quality is similar to the Hunyuan model in the community downloads, but instead of 30 to 40 steps, the fast LoRA renders in 6 to 10 steps. There's no mojo algebra to find the exact right step count. Larger and longer videos will need a few extra steps. Small and short videos, like for animated GIFs, usually need a little bit fewer steps. The difference is in the image quality. There are no hard answers. You'll need to test and decide for yourself. Now, I definitely recommend the fast model. This is the full FP8 model the LoRA was created from. And the level of detail is much higher. I definitely prefer the model over the LoRA. I even prefer fast Hunyuan model over regular Hunyuan. Now, it's still a 13GB model with an additional 8GB text encoder. It's not smaller, it's just faster. And by that I mean it finishes sooner in fewer steps. Now, also in the latest update, we got our first control net for Hunyuan, and it's an image tokenizer for the mood board. It's called LLaVA Image Prompt. It's similar to an IP adapter or like Flux Redux. It scans an image on the mood board and converts what it sees to encoded tokens to communicate directly with the model. LLaVA Image Prompt is included with the community controls. Just select it in the drop-down to download it. And if you forget the name, search for Hunyuan in the control drop-down. Now, that 8GB text encoder I mentioned earlier is LLaVA 3.1 LLaVA, a large language model for analyzing images, and Hunyuan uses this model as its clip encoder. And behind the scenes, embedded in the DrawThings code, there are some AI prompt filters between our straight text prompts and actually communicating with the Hunyuan model. The best I can tell you is that the LLaVA encoder is a bit fussy. And Hunyuan has been trained to respond to a very specific prompt format. That's my assumption. As best I can tell, this control is a token encoder. It's converting the image directly into tokens and feeding that into the model alongside the text prompt. So we have two levers of control. The control weight will boost or reduce the LLaVA image prompt, while our text guidance will boost or reduce the text prompt. They compete a little bit, and they blend concepts too. Now, I notice that sometimes a detail, like a costume, will switch from the mood board description, well, you know, the mood board image, to the model's internal idea of what that outfit should be at certain strength levels. You'll have to play around, and you'll see when the text prompt is stronger or when the image prompt is stronger. Now, obviously, image prompt is not accurate enough to replace initial video. It does influence the composition. I see some image details and, you know, maybe the overall tone, but of course, it is filtered through the LLaVA encoder. It pays attention to certain details and seems to ignore others. I think that's just how LLaVA works. I like it because often I want to influence or the mood and not an exact copy. With image prompt, I can mock up a previous image and get similar composition to the video on the video. But it's not really detailed enough to create consistent clothing or faces. But our last new feature is much more accurate. We can import LoRAs for HunyuanVideo. And this includes the accelerated FastVideo LoRA I mentioned before. Link is in the description. Also, character and style LoRAs. It's just the same as how we can add character and style LoRA to Flux or Stable Diffusion. Now, we can't train Hunyuan LoRA yet, not in DrawThings. And a friend of mine got me to try LoRA training on Fall AI, that's FAL.AI. The process was very easy. There are refreshingly no parameters to set up. I uploaded about 15 to 20 images, the same images I used to train in DrawThings, which are just face shots with solid black or white backgrounds. Now under the More menu, I added my trigger word and I switched off the image captions because my images are too simple for captions. I left the training rate at default. It cost me $5 for 1,000 training steps and it took about 20 minutes. I might get better quality with more steps, but I think the price will start to go up, so... And to use the service, I had to purchase a minimum of $10, so there's a bit of a money commitment just to try this. I trained on two of my characters, and they both turned out really good. I'm happy with the service, and I will use Fala again. Now, at the end of the training, I downloaded the LoRA. I renamed it and imported it into DrawThings. So to do that, you open the LoRA dropdown and select Manage. Find the Import tab. It's the same import file or URL that we saw before. But this time, be sure to select the Hunyuan model for compatibility. Don't leave it set to automatic or it's going to import as Flux and it won't work. Now I'm gonna name the LoRA in a way that I can find it later when I search for it, probably with Hunyuan in the title. I'm adding the trigger word exactly as I said it in the training, and this just adds the trigger to the text prompt so I don't forget. But the trigger does seem to help. Now that's all I have time for. Give this video a like if you think it's going to help other people. And of course you can subscribe to be notified of my next ones. Videos about AI video are weirdly popular on YouTube, so I will be making more as new models and new video features become available in DrawThings. As usual, I hope you had a learn, and I'll see you next time.